just listened to 10 seconds of a baby crying. It felt like longer, didn't it? All babies cry, often for no discernible reason. In general, normal infant crying peaks at 6 to 8 weeks of age, with the average 6-week-old crying for just under 3 hours a day. That's a lot of crying. An organic cause is found in less than 5% of children with excessive crying. Despite that, it is important to consider serious causes of crying in all cases. There are many potential pathologic causes. When investigating infant crying, your history and full physical examination will be your most important tools. There are a few red flags that should prompt further investigation in any child with excessive crying. These include an ill-appearing child, a child with delayed growth or development, or a child who continues to cry inconsolably beyond the time of the initial assessment. Most children who present with excessive crying will be diagnosed with colic. This is a diagnosis of exclusion based on the rule of threes, which includes unexplained crying for more than 3 hours per day, more than 3 days per week, for more than 3 weeks. We don't know what causes colic, and there are no proven effective treatments. Babies with colic cry a lot, but are otherwise healthy and growing and developing normally. Colic has no clear long-term adverse effects for the child. What you should remember about colic is that it is hard on caregivers. Mothers of colicky babies are at higher risk for postpartum depression and are more likely to stop breastfeeding early. Colicky infants are also at higher risk for child abuse. Because of this, providing support to caregivers is critical. Caregivers should be counseled never to shake their baby and given permission to take a break. It is okay to allow the infant to cry in a safe place. Colic generally improves after 6 to 8 weeks of age.